two. That's good. That's good. Hold on. Let's sing I Come to the Garden. This was my daddy's favorite song. Yeah. And he went to be with the Lord February 11 years. It's hard to believe that he's been with Jesus 11 years. He's always been with Jesus, actually. He was a pastor, but he's been with Jesus in the spiritual realm for 11 years now. And it seems like just yesterday. But he loved this song.
I come to the garden all alone. Round you is still on the roses and the voice I hear falling on my ear. The Son of God disclosed. He speaks and the sound of his voice is so sweet. The birds hush their singing and the melody that he gave to me. With him my heart is ringing. With me, and he tells me I am his own, and the joy we share as we tarry there, none other has ever known. I stay in the garden with him, though the night around me be falling. But he bids me go in his voice of woe, his voice to me, his call.
With
me, and he tells me I am his own, and the joy we share as we tarry there, none other has ever known.
Thank you, Jesus. He's always with us.
Praise the Lord. We're going to dismiss our kids to.
Let me say, Chair, I call you, brother.
Thank you, ma'am.
no verse about leaving. Once we come to the garden, we should stay there in His presence. Heavenly Father, I thank You.
Thank You, God.
Lord, for the opportunity once again to stand behind this holy desk and to teach what You have given me to teach this morning. Lord, we thank You for Freedom Life. Lord, we thank You for every church of Christ.
Yes, Lord.
Every church in unity with the body of Christ. Lord, we thank You that we are the bride of Christ. Lord, I thank You for salvation. I thank You for a brand new year. Lord, I thank You for a brand new book to write. Somebody once said, each new year is a new book with 365 new pages.
Thank
and
God.
It depends what we write upon it. Lord, I like Your name. For it's in Your name and Your name only that we can receive salvation.
Yes, Lord.
Lord, we thank You in Jesus' precious, beautiful, magnificent, and majestic name. And the whole church said amen.
Amen.
A brand new year, and I'm going to start it out in teaching in something we should already know, but some of us kind of lose track. What is salvation, and how do I get it?
Amen.
Salvation is defined as deliverance from danger and suffering. As we go through the scriptures and read through the Bible, there are times when salvation is meant as a physical and temporal situation. Philippians 1:19, Paul is delivered from prison. But most often, salvation or being saved speaks of an eternal way of being. In Acts 16:30-31, Paul is talking to the jailer. The jailer says, how should I be saved? And Paul is speaking in his eternal spiritual realm. In Matthew 19:23-26, Jesus Himself speaks of salvation as coming into the eternal kingdom of God. Salvation. What are we being saved from? And believe me, that was a question that I had as a young boy growing up. I kept hearing, you need to be saved, you need to be saved. Saved from what? I didn't have a clue. And now we break it down a little bit. You're saved from hell, and that is not the truth. What we're saved from is God's judgment and wrath. Now, to a degree, that saves us from hell, yes. But sin is a separation between from us and God. We're separated from God, and salvation brings us back into His presence. We're all sinners. We know that. Romans 5:9. 1 Thessalonians 5:19. We're all sinners. None of us are in His presence until we are saved. So salvation not only saves us from His wrath and His judgment and the eternal lake of fire, but salvation also brings us back into a right standing or a presence with God. Salvation gets rid of sin.
Thank You, Lord.
Salvation saves us from the wrath, but it also cleanses us. We are no longer sinners in His sight. Does that mean we're not going to sin again? Of course we're going to. We're born in sin. We're in natural. Our natural state is that of were saved from eternal death in Romans 6 and 23. Biblical salvation is, remember I said it's deliverance from suffering and it's deliverance from danger. Biblical salvation delivers us from the consequences of our own sin. It's the simplest way of saying what I have been saying earlier. We are delivered from the consequences of sin. Now, this is going to get a little, in other words, don't write no nasty letters about this. Going to get controversial for a second. Who does the saving? We say Jesus is our Savior. He is, because we cannot get saved without Jesus. He is our Savior. He is the one who was sent to earth to live, to die, and to be resurrected for our salvation. But Jesus alone is not our salvation. Salvation comes from God. Now that is Jesus, the Son. That is the Father. That is the Holy Spirit. But through Jesus alone, or Jesus alone cannot save us. It takes Jesus' act, which he did, but it also takes our repentance. We cannot be saved without ourselves, believe it or not. We have to do an act of repentance. And then we have to have faith in that salvation. But you know what? That's all we have to do. Repentance, of course, does not just mean, I'm so sorry. It means changing your mind, changing your heart, and turning from that sin. And faith, very simply, means believing that once that's done, you have been forgiven, and through forgiveness, you're saved. It's really simple. Salvation is certainly undeserved. It's a gift. It's a gift given through Christ. Christ, of course, Jesus, was a gift for us. We did not deserve for Jesus to come and walk among us. We do not deserve for Jesus to live within our hearts today. We do not deserve to be led by the Holy Spirit. We do not deserve to be forgiven by the Father, but we are.
Thank you, Lord.
It is a free gift that costs us everything. Today's not the day for that. 1 all the way through the last verse of Revelation. Believe it. There's a great phrase going on. I'm a big wrestling fan. And the world's champion right now is a guy named Roman Reigns, and one of his favorite statements is, believe that. Believe that. You know, Pastor Ray, it seems like God always shuts me up early when you ask me to teach, which is great because it leaves us an open discussion period for a little while. But I do kind of want to mention that we are delivered by the grace of God. It is a free gift that He gives us because we hear, because we believe, because we repent. And I mentioned earlier, Jesus by Himself cannot save us. It takes all three members of the Godhead. But in John 14:6, and this is a thing that is being argued all over the world today, that we've had great TV celebrities. There are more than one way to get to God. I don't know how anybody can say they've ever read the Bible and believe that. John 14:6, Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. The only way to salvation is through Jesus Christ. There is no other way. So let's just put it all real quickly, combine it all. What is salvation? Deliverance from danger or suffering. How do we get deliverance from danger or suffering? Or what are we being saved from? The wrath and judgment of Almighty God. Who does the saving? The Godhead through belief in Christ Jesus. What do we need to do? Of course, be born again. How does that happen? Hear, believe, and repent. I've said it so many times. It boils down, the entire gospel boils down to one verse, and that being John 3:16. Why should we love God? Because He first loved us. He loved us enough to send His only Son to die on the cruelest cross ever invented, to take a trip into hell for us, but to come back with the keys of life and death. Satan's not even smart enough to keep the keys to his own house. Then He was resurrected, brought again to life, so that we could be brought again to life in the eternal and spiritual realm to spend our eternal days with Him in the kingdom of heaven. Hear, believe, very, very simple. see the fruit of what they're doing. Each one of us knows only unto ourselves whether we're saved or not. Anybody can put on the greatest act in the world.
That's right.
I mean, there are Oscar-winning performances every day. Some of them, unfortunately, behind the pulpit. Some of them, unfortunately, behind the worldwide pulpit on national television and international television. Thanks to the satellites that are up now. We don't know who is and who isn't saved, and it doesn't matter as long as I know.